Nigeria's currency weakened by 50 kobo on Wednesday as the dollar was quoted at 386 naira 50 kobo as against 386 naira quoted on Tuesday at the Investors and Exporters I&E Forex window. In the I&E Forex market, trade volumes remained very low due to tightened liquidity. Most participants maintained bids between 380 naira and 391 naira 49 kobo per dollar, according to analysts at the FSDH Research. Now, data from FMDQ indicated that the foreign exchange daily turnover rose by 44.93% to $18.71 million on Wednesday from $12.91 million dollars recorded on Tuesday. The markets opened with an indicative rate of 387 naira 75 kobo on Wednesday at the I&E window. This represents a marginal appreciation of 17 kobo when compared with 387 naira 92 kobo opened with on the previous day. Joining us live now is Mukhtar Mohammed, who is a financial analyst, to make sense of all of these figures. Good to have you, Mr. Mohammed.
Good morning. It's a pleasure being here today.
Thank you for joining us. Let's go straight into the matter, Mukhtar. On the price of the dollar to Naira, what is the reason why you think the CBN is not intervening in the markets yet?
I think the CBN is just being cautious because of the reserve they have, though the reserve can actually defend the currency for the next 6 months. But the CBN is looking at most economy in the world have not really opened. So why intervene in the market when they've not so much of the economic activities yet? And they think that most of what we are seeing, especially during the lockdown and entering now, was due to speculation. So they are trying to look at genuine importers to begin to import some of those goods that, you know, Nigeria need. And so they've opened up that window through the bank whereby genuine importers could import their goods and services at a good interbank rate. But the export and the investment import window is one window that have been used to attract investors. So they're also looking at that, looking at how they can meet demand, both two-way demand. But unfortunately, like your reports, the demand is rising by the day, and the Naira is suffering from a lot of demands for the dollar that the Naira is not able to meet. I mean, the CBN is not able to meet up with.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm wondering, you know, with the current fall of the Naira, can we still be able to attract foreign investors? Help me understand.
Well, it's going to be difficult to attract foreign investors when you look at the volatility, the exchange rate, especially now that the Naira doesn't seem to stabilize, because most foreign investors want to come to you when they realize that the Naira have stabilized and they can have a two-way. When I want to exit, I'm able to exit. So they look for to the CBN to maintain stability, and the CBN can maintain stability through supply. And as it stands now, the CBN is still not intervening in the market. So we may not get investors, foreign investors coming into the market, especially portfolio investors. They want to be sure they are coming at price and they will exit at the right price. So it's a big challenge. And that is why you see that the turnover is rising, but the inflow is not rising at all. So, and I think the CBN knows that. Should be thinking of what about that.
I know that you said the CBN is trying to be cautious, but I'm wondering, what's their role? What should they be doing at a time like this?
Well, the first thing I will tell the CBN to do at the times like this is that CBN should just try to not to panic and watch the market play out, and then we'll be able to intervene at the right time, because as it stands now, they need to know genuine bids to intervene in, and they need to also be cautious of a foreign reserve. And as long as the price of oil is stable at about $40 per barrel, they will be able to meet genuine, but they need to attract foreign investors to bring stability. And that is why they are allowing market factors to play in that space. And I think it's a good decision. But no CBN allow its currency to suffer for a long time. I think one point or the other, the CBN will intervene in the market when they think they will have a robust reserve. But as it stands now, the reserve at approximately 37 $37 billion. It's still they could still intervene for the next 3 months, but I think they want all the economy of the world to be open, mostly Nigerian import partners, before they start intervening directly into the market.
Mm-hmm. I mean, before I let you go, all of this, again, will fall back to Nigerians, will fall back to the people. How does the fall in the Naira affect Nigerians?
Definitely, you know that 90% of our goods are foreign, so it's going to affect it. And you are a lady, you've been going to the market of recent, you see that the cost of goods and services has gone up due to other factors, and also these factors will play in. Just yesterday or during the week, we had the CBN coming out with a circular that they no more will be giving import for importation of maize. And this morning, the maize producer are telling us that they will be dropping in that space about 25%. So when you look at this VAT and VAS, the exchange rate, then you realize that it's going to be hard times. Goods are going to go up. Even the maize that we can easily find will soon be going up. And also you could see that play. That's what is playing out in the pump price, whereby you see the increase in petroleum product, and I mean in crude price, and also affecting the exchange rate, because most of the importers also need to get the exchange. So it's going to play in a lot of, especially imported goods. And you know that Nigerians depend almost 90% of goods from outside. So it's going to be a tough time for the country going forward, with the pandemic also affecting, and the output in terms of the production, oil production also have been reduced, and the foreign reserve is not robust. So all this will play in, and inflation is there to contain. So it's going to result in a lot of hardship for the ordinary Nigerian going forward. And maybe for the short and medium term, maybe for the long term, it could be better if we get our acts together, especially the fiscal policy, because what have kept Nigeria thus far has been the monetary policy. There must be a synergy between the monetary and the fiscal policy for us to enjoy that long-term stability, if at all there will be a long-term stability.
Right. Thank you so very much, financial analyst Mukhtar Mohammed, for helping us make sense of these figures, translating them and putting them in context for us. Do keep safe out there.
Thank you very much. Have a pleasant day, you too. Stay safe.